Minsk of using migrants as a political weapon in retaliation for the sanctions imposed by the West. Lithuania claims Belarus, with the help of Russia and Iran, is facilitating the arrival of international migrants on its border and is now building a razor wire fence to prevent their entry.
The Belarus state airline is flying migrants from Baghdad and Istanbul to Minsk with the promise of visas and coronavirus jabs. From there, they cross the Lithuanian border. On average, the country welcomes 70 migrants in a year. Lithuania has declared a state of emergency, meaning they can lock up new arrivals. The new law also curbs right of appeal and will make deportations easier. To Lithuania and the European Union, this is all President Alexander Lukashenko of Belarus getting revenge for sanctions. "We stopped drugs and migrants. Now you will eat them and catch them yourselves," he said.
The companies that are involved in selling actual tickets to the people in Iraq and other countries, for them to travel via Baghdad, via Istanbul, to Minsk, and then to Lithuanian border. And then when they cross the border illegally to Lithuania and to European Union, they have these documents on their hands. And these documents show that the companies behind them are actually government-run. So that's one thing. Another thing we have on video, how Belarusian border guards are raking and hiding the footprints of the illegal migrants that after they just crossed the border, in order to hide the evidence that actually there was something happening. But we have this on tape.
Are these migrants, though, fleeing persecution or war and in need of genuine help?
Well, we assume that actually this is sold in several countries as a, one could call it even as a tourist trip. Because most these tickets are sold by actual tourist companies. So they're selling an easy way, I would say even quite convenient way, to get to European border and then even to cross it illegally. Because all the example, I mean, the people are telling stories that they've been told where to cross, how to cross, what to tell to the authorities when they meet them in Lithuania. And this is all done by Lukashenko's people.
And you claim that Russia and Iran is involved in this as well. Are these migrants paying for this facility, or are these flights being laid on for free?
I'm sorry, I don't have information about Iran's involvement in this particularly. We know that people are coming from Iraq, actually. And then the biggest group is coming from Iraq. And yes, they are paying. They're paying the price that they are paying from our perspective. I mean, from the information that we have, is quite different. It ranges from 1,500 up to 15,000 euros to get to Lithuanian border.
You have changed the law in the last few days in Lithuania to deal with this. So I think you've collapsed the asylum process, haven't you, just to 10 days now. Are you concerned about the welfare of these people? I mean, you're claiming that this is state intervention and these people are being used as a weapon. What about the welfare of the migrants themselves?
Well, first of all, we think that is not a regular refugee or migration crisis. This is actually a hybrid attack against one of the European and NATO countries, because Belarus doesn't have a border with Syria, Iraq or Afghanistan. So that means that it has to be actively involved in persuading people to come to Belarus and then to lead them to European border. So I think that the biggest challenge now is for Lithuania and for European Union to disrupt the whole network that Belarus started building in order to intimidate Lithuania, intimidate European Union and make to change its policy.
I don't quite follow you. So if 50% of these migrants are from Iraq, where is Belarus actually finding them, locating them, gathering them up and flying them to your border?
Well, from the information that we have, we have to keep in mind that about 90% of people who cross the border illegally, they don't have documents. They are telling us that they were made to destroy their documents when landing in Minsk. That means that the only information that we have is from their from their words, from what they're telling.
Today, over 2,000 refugees live in makeshift camps in Lithuania, and the stream of migrants is not slowing down.
We have come from Belarus. I had no choice. My country is at war, and I wanted to go somewhere that is better, safer for me, where I can live in peace. Any country, maybe.
It was a surprise for all of us, for our village, for the authorities, for all of Lithuania. Many people are trying to help. For example, refugees do not drink tap water, and we all here in the village do, so we have to bring them water from the spring.
Lithuania's defense minister Arvydas Anušauskas went to the border with Belarus to supervise the construction of a barbed wire fence. He said the Lithuanian military will do what it can to